When saving data for telemetry systems and data loggers, you have a few options. The popular ones are removable SD cards and flash chips. SD cards are pretty common, have great library support, and come in a few form factors, including SD and microSD. I love being able to pop out an SD card, take it to my PC, and start looking at graphs and such. But if your project sits in a harsh environment, such as high moisture or bumps and jimmies, operation can be a bit dicey. If you don't call close before a power down, most likely you lose all of your data. Notice the messy information highlighted in the open CSV file. Flash chips, I feel, are less popular because they're a pain to solder in unless you have a hot air soldering station. And they seem to have limited library support. I did come across LittleFS, which mimics full-feature libraries such as SDFAT with file operations, directory operations, and the like. However, my needs of open, write, close on every record brought that library to its knees. Introducing TeensyDB, a database driver that mimics the popular DBase 3 from the 1980s. This database driver lets you create data fields and save records very fast. It's not as fast as LittleFS or SD card saves in volatile mode, meaning when close is outside the save loop, but performance is pretty darn good, around 50 bytes per millisecond. I did a quick test saving to both the chip and an SD card. As you can imagine, the slowest performers were writes where the close operation is called after every write of a record. Record size for this test was around 38 bytes, and after a dozen or so record writes, LittleFS was unusable, at 25 seconds to write 100 records. An SD card using SDFAT started choking around 1,000 writes. If your application can call close after all data is written, performance with either LittleFS and a chip or an SD card is very impressive. TeensyDB took about 4 seconds to write 5,000 38-byte records. And since there is no close operation, there's no chance for lost data. This plot shows 500,000 writes of readings taken from analog read tied to VCC. Any fails in read or write would show as some anomaly. While this is not proof or conclusive data, I've been using this library since 2022 and have written at least 50 megabytes of data and have not lost one bit. Let's first take a look at the wiring. Pin connections are pretty simple. My chip was an 8-pin configuration. Chip select or CE, I connected to pin 6, but you can use just about any chip select, just as long as it supports fast port reading and writing. SO goes to pin 12 for MISO, WP, write protect, is tied to 3.3 volts, VSS, and I don't know why they call it that, is ground, VDD is 3.3 volts, hold is 3.3 volts, SCK is your clock, connected to pin 13, and SI is pin 11 for MOSI. These are the pin settings that I used for a Teensy 3.2 or a 4.0. There's a couple flash chips that I've tested with. I wish I had more. Maybe I'll buy some more and do some further testing. Implementation of the code is pretty simple to do. First, like anything else, include the library. If you want to write to an SD card, you'll have to use your favorite SD card library. Mine happens to be SDFAT. There's a define for the pins and some defines for the sensor pins that I'm using. Of course, here's where your data telemetry or logging comes in. Every time you create a field, you're going to have to note that field, and there's an ID, a return ID, and I've got a few of them listed here. And of course, you're going to need some variables for your data. Create your TeensyDB chip object, and I'm calling mine SSD, passing in the actual pin. If you're using an SD card for dumping your data to an SD card, you will need to create your objects for the SD card itself and the file. Then, simply initialize it in step number one. And step number two is where you're going to create your fields. This really has to be done very first after you call the init. It's simple to create a list of fields. Just call the add field and pass in your data. Notice the ampersand here as we're passing this by reference. This makes all these fields what I will call data aware, meaning with one simple save operation, the library knows where this data is because you've told it, and it will simply populate the chip with all of this data. I've got 7 or so fields here, maybe 8, but you can have up to 255 easily. I do support most of the popular data types, UINT32, INT32s, floats, doubles, chars, but not strings. You shouldn't be using them anyway. Step number three is mandatory, and that is where you have to find your first writable record. How this library works is it writes sequentially on your chip in one big block of contiguous memory. For us to figure out where to write it, we have to know where you ended up. That's what this call does. It's going to return a couple of codes. If it's zero or greater, that means we found some records and it's telling you how many records it found. How big does it know what a record is? That's because of your field definition all up here. That's why you have to call your fields before you do anything else. If you have a new chip, it'll tell you, meaning there are no records. If the chip is full, it'll tell you that. If the chip is invalid, maybe you have a disconnected wire or maybe you put in the wrong chip. If we can't find it, but there's data on there, we will tell you you're going to have to erase your chip. What this means is possibly you erase portions of your chip, not at the end, so there's gaps in your data. We can't find the end if there's gaps in data. And if there's no fields, if you forgot to add your fields and you call this, we're going to let you know pretty quick. I have a cute little menu here to draw a set of options here. Then I'm going to go into a loop. I'll check a key. Of course, here's what the draw menu looks like. Nothing real fancy here, and then a variety of options. So for example, if you want to do something like see what your chip stats are, see if I can scroll down just quick enough. List data statistics. There's a method to call get the field count, get the field length, get the record length, field count, last record. You could get data out of a field, all kinds of neat things you can get with this. Logging data should be no surprise to anybody. However you get your data from your sensors is what you're going to insert into here. Then when it's time to save a record, all you do is add a record, which adds a blank record, and then you call the save and you're done. You don't need to populate any fields, don't need to do anything fancy. Remember, all of the fields had the variable passed in by reference, so this library knows where that data is. Here's where you're telling it to populate the chip with that data. Other options that you have, you can get the chip JEDEC to make sure that whatever you're installing and writing to is what you bought. You can get the use space, get total space, and a few other functions that are in there. If you want to dump your data out to a serial monitor, and I'll show you what that looks like, here's some of the calls that you would use for that. Get the last record to show you how many records are in there, then you can rip through all of the data to get to your last record. Notice this database here starts at 1. There is no such thing called record 0. I try to make it nice and simple. Want to go to record 10? You go to record 10. Then you can get the field and simply print it right out. If you want to dump your data to an SD card, there is a download data example to show you how you do that. Connect to your SD card, hopefully it exists. Create a file of your name choice, and as you saw earlier, simply go to the first record and rip through all of your fields until you get to your very last record and dump all of that to your SD card. All right, let's take a look at what this example can do. I've just increased my interface size a little bit, so hopefully you can see this menu. If you want to take a look at what the chip stats are, just hit S and it will show you what the JDEC is, total use space, and a bunch of other things. Currently I have got about 50 records on this this chip. If you want to see your field list, you can easily see that. And the examples, you can walk through the code and see exactly how I'm printing this out. If you want to print this to the serial monitor, just hit P, and it will show you all of the records that you currently have on your chip. Notice that I've got this concept called a record set ID. You could think of this as a file number, followed by a char for the record name, point, and a few other pieces of information. So I've got record set ID for 0, 1, 2, and so on and so forth. If you want to add to the existing record set, just don't increment that. The library has a way to go and get the last record, tell you what the record set ID is, or whatever your data is, so you can continue on with that. So if you want to add some more, just hit C for continue, print, and now notice how it added some more data for you. If you want to create a new one, then is where you would increment that record set ID. Now, the record set ID concept is something I use. You don't have to use that, but it just gives you an example how you could have sort of a file number type of a scheme. So let's go ahead and print that and see what it looks like. And let's write new. And we have record set 2, 3, and 4, just like that. If you want to download this to your SD card, and I don't have one connected, just hit the D key and it will dump this to your SD card. The example code will show you how you can walk through your entire database and export everything to an SD card. Well, hopefully this library will help you with your telemetry projects. Thanks for watching.